Bipolar disorder is one of the major mood disorders, affecting about 3% of the population. Known in the past as manic depression, bipolar disorder involves episodes of both extreme sadness and euphoria or irritability, together with other symptoms, and often develops in the teen years. For many people, bipolar disorder is also linked to heart problems, says Dr. Benjamin Goldstein, one of Canada's foremost experts on this condition.
People that have bipolar disorder have a far increased risk of heart disease compared to the general population. And this gives us cause for concern because they have onset of heart disease at much earlier ages, about 10 to 15 years younger than the general population does.
That's why Sunnybrook is leading an innovative new study. For the first time, comparing blood vessel functioning of teens with bipolar disorder and healthy teens to look for clues about heart disease risk. They'll do that by using high-resolution ultrasound and a blood test.
Teenagers are at very low risk of having a heart attack during their teenage years, but we do have a proxy for heart disease risk, which is called endothelial function. It's a marker of how healthy blood vessels are, and we can measure this in people's arms in a non-invasive and painless way. And what we're looking at is testing the hypothesis that certain proteins that have been linked with bipolar disorder, such as markers of inflammation and markers of proteins that relate to brain health, may explain some of the difference between patients with and without bipolar disorder.
About 10 patients have already been recruited for this study, and Dr. Goldstein and his team plan to enroll another 65 over the next 2 years. The study will also look at how different treatments may affect the risk of heart disease in people with bipolar disorder. For more information, visit the Sunnybrook website. With Sunnyview, I'm Monica Mattis.